बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम स्टूडेंट इन दिस लेक्चर। टुडे आवर टॉपिक नेम इज प्रैक्टिस क्वेश्चंस रिलेटिंग टू लीनियर कॉस्ट रेवेन्यू एंड द प्रॉफिट फंक्शंस। दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस लेक्चर एंड दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 15। हियर आई सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। द स्टेटमेंट इज A manufacturer of microcomputers produced 3 different models. The following table summarized wholesale price, material cost, per unit cost and labor cost per unit and annual fixed cost are $25 million. Annual fixed cost are $25 million. So the briefing of total question statement is shown in the following table, where you see there is a firm whose name is microcomputers, and it has 3 departments, M1, and it produces 3 types of model. Model number 1 I write here M1, then M2 and M3. Here you see here wholesale price per unit, wholesale price per unit for model 1 is $500, for model 2 is $1000, and for model 3 is $1500. And then material cost per unit, that the firm bearing, that is $175 for model 1, then $400 for model 2 and $750 for model 3. Labor cost per unit, that is 100 for model 1 and 150 for model 2 and 225 for model 3. Here the first requirement, that is, he says that determine a joint total revenue function for sale of the 3 different micro models. First you have to develop a revenue model. First you have to determine a joint revenue model. So in the start of this question, let us suppose that the model number 1, that the units produced for model number 1, that is represented by X1, then M2, that is X2, and the units for M3 are equal to X3. Now here we know that what is the formula for finding the total revenue, that is total revenue is equal to price multiplied by the units, price multiplied by the unit. Here we have 3 types of models whose units are produced, that is the first model multiplied by its price, then second model multiplied by its price, and the units of third model multiplied by its price. Here in question statement you see that the price of first model is, that is 500. So I write at the place of P1, that is 500, then at the place of P2 I write 1000, and then at the place of M3 I write, place of P3 I write 1500. So here the revenue based on 3 types of products, that is M1, M2 and M3, and their units names are X1, X2 and X3 respectively. So the revenue based on these 3 products is equal to 500 X1 plus 1000 X2 plus 1500 X3. This is our total revenue model. Now in part B, determine an annual cost function. Determine an annual cost function for manufacturing the 3 models. Determine an annual cost function for manufacturing the 3 models. And we know that cost function, that is based on 3 types of costs, 3 types of models cost, that is X1, X2 and X3, which are the units produced by these models, is equal to the cost of first model multiplied by its units, the cost of the second model multiplied by its units, cost of the third model multiplied by its units plus the labor cost. The labor cost bear by the firm on first model, that is L1 multiplied by its units. Then labor cost at the second model multiplied by its units plus labor cost bearing by the third model multiplied by its units plus the annual cost. Plus the annual cost. So I substitute here, as you see, here you see that the cost, material cost per unit, material cost per unit, here you see that material cost per unit, that is for M1 is equal to 175, then M2 is equal to 400 and M3 is 7500. In this way, the labor cost per unit is equal to 100, then 150, and then 225. And you see here, annual fixed cost are $25 million. Sorry student for disturbance. Here you see that where I am stating here the annual fixed cost are $25 million. Now we substitute their respective values. Here you see at the price at the place of C1 I write 175, you can see from the above table, and then multiplied by its units. Then the cost of second model, that is 400, and multiplied by its units, then the cost of third model and multiplied by its unit, plus the labor cost bearing by the first model, that is 100, and multiplied by its units, then 150 into X2 plus 225 X3, and plus the annual cost, that is $25 million. So it is equal to 2 crore and 50 lakh. So in this way, when I add up these 175 plus 100, this is equal to 275, then 400 plus 150, that is equal to 550, then 750 plus 225, that is equal to 975 x3 plus 2 crore 50 lakh. Okay, this is our cost model. This is our cost model. Now we move towards part C, in which it states that determine the profit function for the sales of the three models. Determine the profit function for sales of the three models. And we know that profit function is equal to revenue minus cost. Revenue minus cost. Here the profit function based on three types of models. So I write P, X1, X2, X3, then I write revenue R, X1, X2, X3, and the cost C, X1, X2, and X3. Now I substitute their respective values here. First I write the values of revenue function here. You see here. Here you see 500X1 plus 1000X2 plus 1500X3. Here you see 500X1 plus 1000X2 plus 1500X3. Then I write in the parenthesis the value of the cost function, that is 275 x1 plus 550 x2 plus 975 x3 minus there is a mistake here, there is a positive sign here. So when I open this bracket and simplify this, I get, when I open this parenthesis and simplify this, we find the final value is this 225 x1 plus 450 x2 plus 525 x3 minus 2 crore and 50 lakh. Now part number D, what is the annual profit of the firm if it sells 20,000 units of first model, 40,000 units of second model and 10,000 units for the of the third model respectively? What is the annual cost, annual profit? We have to find the annual profit if these are the models of x, these are the models of first M1 and these are the models of M2 and these are the model of M3. If these models are sell in the market, then how much profit earned by the firm? So I write here, substitute x1 is equal to 20,000, x2 is equal to 40,000 and x3 is equal to 10,000. So I substitute these values in the above model, above equation, and we get that, and after simplification we get 27 lakh 50,000. Now we move towards question number 6. That is, for example number 5, page 181, the board of directors has voted on the following planting program for coming year. 1000 acres will be planted at firm 1 and 1600 at firm 2 and 1550 at firm 3. What are the expected profit for the program? What are the expected profit for the program? If they are using this information, if they are working according to this information, if they are planting 1000 acres in the firm 1 and 1600 in the firm 2 and 1550 at firm 3. So in as a solution, you see here example number 5 from the book, which is at page number 181. Its total profit function you see at page number 182. I have given you the total information here, in which you see here the profit function of the three firms is equal to revenue minus cost, and I write the final answer, which is at page number 182. I am writing here 400 x1 plus 550 x2 plus 450 x3 minus 525 000. Now I substitute the previous information which is given in the question, that is, I substitute now x1 is equal to 1000, x2 is equal to 1600 and x3 is equal to 1550. So you see here, when I substitute these values at the place of x1, x2 and x3, you see here after simplification it is equal to 14,52,500. 14,52,500. Part B, see example number 5, solution page 182. Here the revenue function is, in this part he says that if the revenues of the of three firms are reduced by first firm for 20% and second firm the revenue of the first firm reduced by 20% and the revenue of the second firm is reduced by 30% and the revenue of the third firm is reduced by 10%, then you calculate how much profit this firm will earn. So I write here 1300 and I calculate its 20% of 20% of the 1300, and then I subtract this value from 1300 and I get 1040. Then I calculate the 30% of 1650 and subtracted that value from 1650 and I get 1155. Then I calculate the 10% of 1200 and that value subtracted from 1200, that is equal to 1080. So our new revenue function will be, that is equal to R X1, X2, X3 is equal to 1040, as you see here, 1040 X1. Reduced from, as you see here in the previously, it is 1300 X1. Now it is 1040 X1, then 1155 X2, and then 1080 X3. In this way, total profit function will be P of X1, X2, X3 is equal to R of X1, X2, X3 minus C of X1, X2 and X3. Here I write the revenue function which I have now obtained after made changing. That is 1040 X1 plus 1155 X2 plus 1080 X3 minus. Then I write the cost function, which is defined at page number 182 of example number 5. Here 900 X1 plus 1100 X2 plus 750 X3 plus 525 000. When I simplify this, it is equal to 140 X1 plus 55 X2 plus 330 X3 minus 525 000. Now we put the same values here. I substitute here X1 is equal to 1000, X2 is equal to 1600 and X3 is equal to 1550. When I substitute these values in this function, I get 214,500. Here you see the profit at the previous values is equal to 14,52,500, and now after reduction in the revenue of the three firms, it is now equal to 214,500. In this case, expected profit will be 214,500 if the revenue of the first firm reduced by 20% and the revenue of the second firm reduced by 30% and revenue of the third firm reduced by 10%, then the firm will be able to earn a profit of 214,500. Now we move towards question number 7, that is, a car leasing agency purchases new cars each year for the use in the agency. The car cost $15,000 new. They are used for 3 years. After which they are sold for $4,500. After the use of three years, then they will they sell the car at $4,500, which they are purchased new at cost $15,000. The owner of the agency estimate that the operating the cars exclusive of gasoline are $0.18 per mile. Cars are leased for a fee of $0.33 per mile. First question he asks, formulate the total revenue function associated with renting one of the cars total X miles over the 3 years period. So you see here, one car which is leased for fee, that is $0.33 per mile. So in this way, this $0.33 is his profit. The price he charged. So I write revenue is equal to 0.33x. Now part B, formulate the total cost function associated with the renting a car for a total of x miles over 3 years. Formulate the total cost function associated with renting a car for a total of x miles over 3 years. So you see here, cost is equal to variable cost plus fixed cost. Variable cost, you see here, variable cost is the gasolines, the expense that bear by the company, that is the gasoline expense. And this is per mile, its value is $0.18. So you see here, that is the variable cost, that is 0.18x plus fixed cost, mean here the value of the car originally that they buy at the time, and then at what value they sell. So fixed cost is equal to the original value of the car, that is 15,000, then minus, that is the cost of the car at which they sell the car, that is 4,500. We subtract this value of 4,500 from 15,000, its value, then its value become 10,500. Now part C, formulate the profit function. So you know that profit function is equal to revenue minus cost. Here I substitute the value of the revenue function, that is 0.33x minus cost function is equal to 0.18x plus 10,500. When I subtract this 0.18x from 0.33x, we get 0.15x. And this negative 10,500. Now part D, what is the profit if the car is leased for 60,000 miles over a 3 years period? What is the profit if the car is leased for 60,000 miles over a 3 years period? Here you substitute x as here in our equation, x represent the number of miles. X represent the number of miles. So you substitute x is equal to 60,000 in the above function. So when I substitute this 60,000 at the place of x, we get 0.15 into 60,000 minus 10,500. When I simplify this, it gives a negative value. It gives a negative value, which is not a profit, it is a loss. If they leased a car for 60,000 miles, then the company will goes into loss condition. So now in part E, he asked what mileage is required in order to earn a zero profit for 3 years. The minimum miles that a firm, that a car runs, so that its profit will be zero. So what mileage is required in order to earn a zero profit for 3 years? So you see here, the value is P of x is equal to 0.15x minus 10,500. Substitute P of x is equal to zero. So zero is equal to, and you know that this point is also called the break even point. This zero profit is also called the break-even point. So to find that mileage, we substitute P of x is equal to 0, and we get 0.15x minus 10,500. When I take this towards left side, it is equal to 0.15x is equal to 10,500. So x is equal to 10,500 divided by 0.15, and it is equal to, when we finalize this, this is equal to 70,000 miles. If one unit is less than 70,000, then firm will not earn the profit, it bear loss. So to earn zero profit, it must produce 70,000, its car must cover a mileage of 70,000. And the remaining two questions are, so far complete exercise is solved by myself. two questions remains in the exercise, that is question number 8 and 9, and these questions are given you as an assignment. Inshallah Taala, I will after some time I will post that assignment, or like we say the practice question in the form of a practice question. I will send you in the Google Classroom, through Google Classroom, and we plan that how is it possible for our teacher side that your quiz, online quiz, should be conduct. Inshallah, within next week I will announce that how your quiz will be conducted. So take care, stay home, and stay safe. Inshallah, we will meet in our next lecture. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.